So I mention it, right? And they go, oh, we got to go to the doctor. I went over there today, and my doctor, Dr. Kawashiri, can I say his name?
You can't.
Well, you just did.
Yeah, you
did. He's a great guy.
Yeah, he's a good guy.
Yeah, he's one of the best. Don't bleep it.
Okay, I'll make it louder.
Yeah, maybe maybe there's some promotion there for him.
Oh, good.
Yeah. Maybe start.
Does he specialize in Asians?
I mean, with a last name like that.
You know what's weird? He could. he could because.
I go to my doctor, Dr. O'Houlihan. he specializes in cirrhosis of the liver.
Yeah. Maybe I should switch it up.
Yeah.
Maybe I should get a black doctor or something. Yeah. It seems.
Could you be a little more woke?
And maybe,
go to another race for your doctoring.
So,
all right,
so he goes. I tell him the problem. And he goes, okay, so, Bobby, depend over. And I, you know, I've never been like one to go. Are you sure about bending over? Like I'm like, you know me, I jump in. Mm-hmm. If there's a party, I'll jump in. So I bend over, take my pants off, obviously, right? And
what did you do first?
Oh, that's interesting. That's interesting.
Oh, yeah.
That's interesting. I think I fucking bent over.
I just thought that was going to get a laugh.
No.
I thought it was a ridiculous question. Josh, you're going to break it. He just goes, oh, that's interesting.
No.
I thought that was interesting.
You know, because you...
I can't believe you're going to answer this.
A normal person would have taken the pants off first and then bent over.
Yeah.
But what you just said was, I did bend over first and then took my pants off.
Wow. Of course you did. That's so fucking weird. Oh my gosh.
And I bent over and there was that moment where the doctor goes, you know what I mean?
Oh my God.
What are you doing? Right? And I go, I know how it works. This is the way I do it. Right? So I bent over. Then
I like it. You made it weird back.
Yeah. I reversed it.
You took control of the weirdness. I like it. Now he's weirded out.
Right. And he goes,
what are you waiting for, big boy?
So he does, you know, you hear a noise like something's coming out of a tube.
Okay.
Right? So he has to put the lube on and whatnot. He has the glove on. And then he doesn't, you know, he Pearl Harbors it. I mean, I know it's Kawashiri. But instead of...
What is Pearl Harbor? He told you he was doing it.
He didn't fly around the island. He went...
Yeah, but he told you he was doing it. It wasn't a sneak attack.
He
said, hey, sit down next to me.
Because I want a 3-2-1. Don't you want a 3-2-1 when it comes to your asshole? Someone yelling that out?
I'd rather rip the Band-Aid off.
No, not me. Don't you want that?
Well, there's supposed
to. I will be entering your asshole in three.
Yes!
Two.
So I can, clinch or whatever my body does.
They usually say, going to be a little cold because of the cold
loop. He said nothing.
You're going to feel over. A little pressure.
Is
a classic medical.
And I bent over, pull the pants out, and then banzai is what I... banzai! Then he goes, it's just my index finger, right?
Yeah.
I go, no, that was your thumb, bro. He thumbed it.
You're positive.
I don't have reverse, you know what I mean?
Sight.
Reverse sight. Yeah. I mean, I don't know if there's cameras in the room, but I think he fucking thumbed it. It hurt. Or I might have a tight asshole.
Or he has short fingers.
I never thought of the third fucking option.
Yeah.
Yeah, he could
Maybe
have short
he's got
fingers.
Little hands.
Maybe he's got little hands.
You probably gave him a complex. He came home all moody, and his girlfriend's like, what's the matter? I don't want to talk about it. What's the matter? It happened again. What happened? Oh, I put my index finger in somebody's asshole, and they were convinced it was my thumb. You don't understand. It's a man thing, okay?
Yeah. Maybe. I might have fucked his day up. But good news is that I don't know how he checks, but he goes, no blood.
Well, you're not going to know for a while, sweetheart.
No, but he goes, that's a big thing. He goes, there's no traces of blood in the entrance of the calamari. So he's like, you know, he said that, you know, because I'm going to Hawaii Friday. So I don't want to be like, do I have colon cancer or.
Yeah, but you can't. You're going to need a colonoscopy. You're almost 50.
Did you do one?
Yeah. It's the easiest thing ever.
Yeah.
Like, okay, this is going to smell like peppermint. And then 5 seconds later, it's like, all right, your ass is great. No problems. That's literally what it feels like.
Yeah, but she was saying...
What sucks is the day before the stuff you have to drink is a little bit gross. But when you're weighing that versus dying of ass cancer, it's just like, all right, yeah, I'll choose this.
Yeah, yeah. I'm just going to tell you how I discovered you.
I do owe my whole career to you. Yeah. I was struggling until Bobby Lee discovered me.
Not discover you in terms of like you did it on your own, obviously, but no, in terms of my awareness of you.
Oh.
Can I tell you that story?
No, I remember it was a big day in my career. Bobby Lee is finally aware of me. Am I on Bobby Lee's radar?
See, this is what he's going to do.
This is when things start to happen.
I'm not going to allow this to happen.
Reversal.
I'm not going to allow this to happen.
Reversal.
Yeah, yeah. I'm just going to plug away. You know what I mean?
Listen, you can talk to him all you want. I can hear it. So plexiglass. It's not soundproof.
So years ago, I had no idea who you were. And I was in a car with Steve Byrne and Ken Jeong, and we're driving from San Francisco to LA because we had to do gigs together at that time because we couldn't draw on our own. And so Steve Byrne loved Oasis. Mm-hmm. We kept playing Oasis over and over again. Like
he still does.
I know, right? It's like, give it a rest, right? They have three songs, good songs, Champagne Supernova, Wonderwall, and some other one, okay?
Don't Look Back in Anger.
That's it. Great songs, but that's it. So we go, well, what do we listen to? And he goes, well, I have a friend from New York. You know, I have his comedy CD. And we're like, I don't fucking listen to fucking comedy right now, bro. What the fuck?
Yeah.
You know what I mean? We're fucking 8 hours in the fucking car. We have to drive fucking with some open micers fucking CD, whatever, right? He puts it in. No, it was very funny. But there was one bit about you in the subway, and then you saw some guy pick a girl up. And then your high-pitched voice, you know what I mean?
Oh, yeah, I was grabbing it by the back of the neck.
He's hurting me! Yeah. Or the bit, right?
Yeah.
And we laughed so hard. And that's when, you know what I mean, went out, oh, Bill Burr, Bill Burr, Bill Burr. And then, now you're one of the greatest comics on the planet. How does that feel?
What was that character you just... I don't even take it.
No, it's just...
I'm plugging away. I'm doing all right. You're doing all right.
Well, it's great because of the fact that it's like, you know, here's the deal. The honest truth is this.
I just love that whole body line. Okay,
here's the deal.
Let's get real.
Let's get real. So, you know, I'm almost 50, and I feel like things are kind of slowly happening for me as well, right? It's just nice to see, like,
what are you talking about? You've been on fucking television for like almost 30 years.
What are you talking about?
Mad TV.
Oh my God.
And everything else.
Okay, first of all, Mad TV was like doing community theater. That's how much we got paid.
I'm just telling you. Did you get fucked over in show business? Did you think there was a big pot of gold and then somebody else took it from you? Yeah, that's what happens. But you were still on TV. You still walk down the street and people are like, oh my God, it's Bobby Lee from Mad TV.
Okay, fine. Fine. You're right. And I'm grateful. Okay. But I'm just saying
the amount of empathy that I have for you right now is just awful.
Thanks, Bill.
How much of your day is trying to pick this up and keep it buoyant?
I know. See, the thing about him, though, I have to stand, okay?
Yeah, yeah, go ahead.
The thing about him is that...
I feel like I'm getting cross-examined.
Yeah, the thing about him is that he has ways... He's one of those guys, like Whitney is like that, too.
Mm-hmm.
Where she sees, you know, me behaving in a certain way to garner some sort of sympathy, or, you know, I'm doing something psychological, right? So that I can get something out of some, and he sees through it, where other people, they fall into it, and they go, oh, no, you know what I mean? And they, you know what I mean?
I've just been around a lot of dirtbags, so I
yeah.
I've been taken advantage of a couple of times. Yeah, yeah. I know when it's happening.
Yeah, but you could see through that. But I'm just saying that... let's go back to what I was doing originally, which is you're doing well, and congratulations. That's all I wanted to fucking say.
Thank you. I appreciate God. That. I appreciate that.
I mean, you're killing it. I love The Mandalorian, right? All of a sudden, I didn't even know you were on it. And when you're watching something you love, right, and then you see a guy that you know up there killing it, you go, oh, my God, it's fucking crazy, right? And then, like, and then he's in the Avatar movie, mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And a bunch of, you know, he's killing it. That's all I wanted to say. I know you don't like compliments.
I caught up to you.
I know you don't like compliments. why do comics not like compliments?
I know. I think some of them do. Look, I respect, you know, other comics liking what I do. I do enjoy that shit, but I don't want to sit here and just like listen to that.
You're giving him the worst experience.
I just want to like hang out and make whoever's watching this laugh. You don't have to go James Lipton.
Because when a girl sees my penis for the first time, yeah. I get this sound.
Oh wow.
That's it.
Wow.
Yeah.
Wow.
Not like a baby. You know, I've heard comics talk about like, you know, girls making baby sounds. Like, oh yeah. No, it's more like, like a question.
I actually think it's bigger than assumed.
Thank you.
Well, that's the thing. You, key to life is low expectations. So I think he like very smart. If you have a smaller size dick, you say it's the smallest thing in the world, and then when girls imagine it, it's almost not there. Then they see it, they're like, wait a minute, that's not the smallest thing. I know what you're up to. This is what you do. This is your shtick.
Yeah.
You're the smartest guy in the room, and you act like the dumbest guy in the room.
Yeah.
I know what you do.
But I do this. I
know you.
Before though, but I used to do this as a comedian, right?
This guy.
I would like meet a girl. Like this is before I was on TV, right. And I know that I had a 15-minute set that destroyed.
Yeah.
But I would meet a girl and I go, I'm all right, I'm average, right?
Yeah.
And then you bring them in the room, right? And then you destroy, right? And then, you know what I mean? Yeah, baby, that's how I do it.
And then you started doing it with your dick. You started doing the same thing with your dick as you did with the comedy.
Yeah.
Yes,
dude. I always lowball things, dude. In fact, when I go into any job, I always think the worst is going to happen.
So you prepare yourself for disaster.
Yes.
And then if it doesn't happen, it's a success.
It's a success.
Yeah, because if I go in there with, I've done this before where I was in that movie, The Dictator.
Yes.
And I would go, I'm going to kill it. This is my time to shine. And then there was like a couple of scenes where it was like not working.
Yeah.
You know, and like people are like, you know how they mumble at Video Village?
Ah.
So you do its take and then all the producers and the directors, they get in a huddle and they go,
no, that wasn't it.
That was terrible. You know what I mean? And they look back at it and like, oh, why did we hire that guy? And whatever they say.
Oh.
I hate that, right?
So
I
go in. Do you ever have like a Tom Cruise blow up or do you ever like really go for it?
Dude, what do you think of his blow up?
I respected it.
He did it for you. Literally, like, nobody has a blow up and only positive shit.
But let me just say,
we gotta save the turtle. Like, right? Like, who gets angry and doesn't curse and just says positive things? If he dropped like an N bomb in the middle of it, I'd be like, oh, okay, this guy really. He just was the best guy.
Yeah.
Like, we gotta save people's lives and their college education.
I have a theory that I think that was a PR move.
Yes.
But that's just because I think that, you know, his stocks have dropped since the whole David Miscavige thing. What? And he keeps doing these big action movies, but he's really kind of out of the Oscar contender kind of category.
Oh.
So I think that was his attempt to kind of
galvanize support in the industry and like make him look like a good guy, like he can.
Because it worked on me.
Exactly. Yeah, because you really care about Corona.
I'm
immune. So I'm like, you fucking pussy.
But he used his power, and that's when you know he has power. Because if I would have done it, this is what would happen, right? Hey guys, I'm gonna tell you right now, and then somebody would go, "Fuck you," and it's the fucking gopher, right? Or the guy holding the boom. Fuck you, sit down, Chinaman, right? And I'd be like, "Oh, I'm sorry," right? Whereas they let Tom go, and I'm gonna say this. That last fucking Mission Impossible movie he did.
Bomb?
Dude, one of the best action movies I've ever fucking
seen. He's a beast.
He's a beast.
He's a weirdo, but he's a beast, though.
Yeah.
That's the thing. Like, if he was funny, he'd probably be one of us.
Mm.
Like, he's weird enough to be one of us. He's just not funny.
No, but you know, I have to admit, he was in Tropic Thunder.
He thought he was really acting.
No, but he was funny.
I don't think he was trying to be funny. I thought he was, it was a serious thing. They were like, seriously,
really?
Be this. We need you to be that guy.
Yeah. Yeah, he is a weirdo, but you know what, dude? It just shows his power.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
You could probably do that on your new Netflix show.
Damn right I could.
Yeah. Is it a show or a special? What is it?
I mean, it's an hour special that we broke up in four episodes, so it's like 15 minutes each.
Right. And it's what you were doing on
Instagram.
Instagram.
Literally, yeah.
And then they put it on Netflix.
Yeah, we just filmed like longer versions of it.
Yeah.
I love how the last time you were here, we were talking so much shit about Netflix.
Bro, I had to do it.
But now I know how it works.
That's how it works, yeah, right? Like, how do you get laid? By like telling a girl she's amazing? Yeah. Or being like, right. Oh, no, I got another girl.
Yeah, what's that? Wait, you know what I mean? Wait, what's that book that people used to
Neil
guys
Strauss,
used to read?
The yeah. Fucking How Do Dorks Get Laid.
Yeah, so yeah, one yeah. of the things
is negging?
Negging.
No, what you do is, if you see four girls, this is what I read. I met the guy once.
Yeah.
You see four girls at a bar.
I
right?
hate it already, but go ahead.
And you see the one that you don't like, that you do like.
Uh-huh. You don't pay attention to her.
You don't pay attention, or you do condescending like remarks.
Negging.
Yeah, you dig it. You see something like you call that hair. Like, what are we in the 80s? And then you start like you're gonna be hitting on the ugly one. That one is gonna like you.
I somehow don't think that would work.
Yeah, it does.
It's weird.
It works,
works, but it's some loser shit because you like got like lower girl's self esteem so that she'll like you.
Exactly.
It sucks. I hate the idea of it, but. Yeah. And initially when I was...
you see?
Yeah.
It is but what you, it is. If it works, it works.
It works.
Now, that when I was talking crazy shit, it wasn't like, oh, this is how I'm going to get them.
Mm-hmm.
It was literally just because it was like, well, I got nothing to lose. If they don't fuck with me, it's fuck you. If you don't fuck with me, it's fuck you. That's the way I go.
Yeah.
Whereas a lot of people, I think, in my situation are just like, well, I'll just keep on being nice and hopefully I'll bump into them at like Moon Tower. I'll win them over at the bar later that night. I'm like, nah, if you don't fuck with me, it's fuck you.
Yeah.
And we kept making, you know, dope shit. Words. If you're shitty with women, hey, there's a lot of dudes that are shitty with women. Dude.
Yeah.
I'm not saying it's okay, but we all know there's a lot of dudes that are shitty with women. And there's a lot of women that are down to fuck shitty dudes. Let's keep it real. You know what I'm saying? Like, there's a lot of girls that hang out at the Comedy Store really just trying to suck dicks.
Yeah.
That's a true thing that happens. You've seen them there, I'm sure.
I was with a woman once, and she lived at my house for. So I rolled up at the Comedy Store, right?
Don't
and
say
there's
her name.
What?
Don't say her name.
I'm not gonna say her name.
Yeah.
And she's just standing there in the parking lot, just a regular white woman.
Yeah.
She's beautiful.
A beautiful white woman.
Okay.
What is that shape you're making?
Yeah. I don't understand the shape.
A whole lot. It's more nine curves.
Yeah. She was wobbly. You know what I mean?
Okay.
She's bigger?
Yeah.
She's
No. She's normal.
So now it's this.
Yeah. I fucked it up.
What's the shape of her body?
Try again with your head.
I'll be real. Okay. If you want to be real, her shape was like this.
Dude. Okay.
She's a hot chick.
She's a piece.
Why do we start?
I don't know.
You're wild.
I'm wild.
You're wild. Okay.
So
she's a piece.
I get out of my car.
Total piece.
Yeah, and she comes up to me, and this you know that this is like, you know, I mean, I should have like, you know what I mean, like alerts in my head, right?
Yeah.
But she just went, you know what I mean, you're cute, which is like already like, come on, what the fuck?
Mm-hmm.
And she's like, I'm a fan of your comedy. You know what I mean?
Yep.
Now I'm half hard.
You are. Yep.
Half.
Yep.
Right? Not full. Right?
Yep.
She goes, I live here, a different city.
Okay.
I drove here.
Okay. You mentioned the city before.
Yeah.
Earlier.
I'm from Bakersfield.
Barstow.
No, she's from
Barstow.
Bakersfield.
Oh, she's from Bakersfield.
Bakersfield, yeah.
Okay.
Barstow has a great Del Taco. Do not knock Barstow.
Yeah.
Wait. I'm sorry. That specific Del Taco is amazing.
Oh, Andrew, if you're going to do anything in Barstow, if you happen to drive from here to Vegas and you stop in Barstow and do not get a Del Taco, I will be so disappointed in you.
Can I tell you something?
Yeah.
I know what fucking Del Taco you're talking about.
Right?
Barstow is on the way to Vegas.
Yes.
And there is one town.
Yes.
Yes.
And there's a fucking Del Taco that is right off of that highway that you take to Vegas.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And you ate
there. And I've never eaten there. No, but there's a gas station that's next to that Del Taco.
There's a few things there. They also have a Taco Bell. There's a Panda Express. There's a Chevron. It's a small.
Maybe I'm not thinking about that Del Taco. Yeah. But it is Barstow. I'm thinking.
Can we let go of the fucking Del Taco?
No.
Can we let go?
It's just so weird to be like, oh, like to say a fast food place, which is like the entire brand is making the food the same in every place.
Yeah.
To be like this one.
Not in Barstow. I think the Barstow one, I don't think I'm wrong on this, might be the original one.
Ah, okay.
Yeah.
Okay, fair enough. But anyway, go back to the story.
So there's this...
There's this girl. She's from Bakersfield.
Right.
And
she goes, I drove here. I don't want to drive home.
Oh, yeah.
Can I spend the night at your house?
Right? Okay.
And I was single at the time.
Okay.
And she was a beautiful woman. So I go, okay. All right. So we sit there and we watched MTV.
Let's go.
Yeah. right.
Set the mood.
Yeah.
Like fucking Aziz.
Yeah, yeah.
Dude, that's how I know Aziz was a nerd. When he put on Seinfeld. To fuck.
Yeah. And then she.
What a dork, right? Let's set the mood.
Is that what the girl said?
Yeah, she said he put on Seinfeld. Dude, these pretzels are making me thirsty. You fucking dork. Yeah. Come on, buddy. Put on Mission Impossible.
So she, we're watching MTV and then she pulls out a titty. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean?
God,
which is like,
it.
You know, it's a sign.
Singular?
One titty.
What was the shirt like?
It's like a loose t-shirt. And
she pulled it
out
up top?
Yeah.
That's savage.
Right? And it was like, you know, I remember the nipple.
Yeah.
Pinkish.
Yeah.
Right? And with, you know, I'd never sucked a titty before I made out with a girl before.
Okay.
Right? It's like kind of eating like the dessert before the meal almost.
Completely reasonable.
Right.
Yeah.
But I went for the dessert.
You have to.
Because the titty's out.
She opened it up.
Wait, yeah. Did she stretch the collar of the t-shirt?
No, it was like a loose, like, you know, all saints.
This is a responsible woman right here.
I'm sorry, you don't do that.
Yeah, I understand everything right now. Like, not like I hadn't before.
Yeah.
But like the level of responsibility that while you're talking about this girl that you may have had sex with, she's going, not what a slut for fucking you the first night. She's going, who stretches the collar? girl is trash. Like, I'm stretching your shirt?
That's like next level.
I'm also offended by you saying I may have had sex with her.
I don't know. I'm
telling you I did.
Well, now you're telling me, but I'm not going to put that on you.
Okay, but I'm telling you that I did.
Okay.
Because I'm a closer.
That's what you... Oh.
All right.
Were you laying up? Bye.
So a titty was out, right? And went for the titty.
Got
right?
him.
Sucked it, right? And then, so she started living at my house.
No.
Yeah. For like a week.
Oh, yeah.
She wouldn't leave.
Okay.
You know what I mean? And we were just on the kitchen table, all kinds of stuff, right?
Yeah.
It was great. And then, by the seventh day in, we were at a restaurant.
Okay.
And I had a comic call me and go, yo, dude, that girl you're hanging out with, don't bring her to the club.
Uh-oh.
And I go, why? He goes, because I'm bringing my girlfriend. Right? And I'm like, why does that matter? Why would that matter, right?
Yeah.
Bro, we're all fucking that girl.
So she was getting rinsed.
Yes.
Interesting.
Yes.
Just so then, rinsed.
We're at dinner, and I get off the phone with my friend.
Oh, yeah.
Right? And I turn to her.
Oh, God.
And I go,
are you getting rinsed?
Are you being rinsed by other comics?
Yeah.
Right? And she goes,
are you getting your fanny rinsed?
Right. And I go, can you tell me who? Right. Yeah. She goes, you have a pen and a piece of paper?
No.
Yeah. Right. She started like, you know what I mean? It was like the Dead Sea Scrolls. It was just like, you know what I mean? She had to unravel. Yeah, she's unraveling. Yeah. It was like, you know what I mean? The list, open micers. Oh, I mean, you know what I mean? New York comics, Midwest comics. You know what I mean?
Open micers.
Yeah, it was
that's
like crazy.
The most insulting part. Yeah,
I know. And I looked at her and I go, we can't do this.
Yeah.
And you know what the most insulting thing is?
What?
So a couple years later.
Oh, God.
Oh, God. Comes up to me and he mentions her name. He goes, do you know so-and-so? I go, yeah. And I go, did you? He goes, did you? And I go, yeah. And then 2 days later, he comes back up to me and he goes, yeah, I'm seeing her. I asked her. She never did it with you. She didn't. She admitted to the Dead Sea Scrolls, right? 50,000 names, right?
But
she fucking left. She denied. She fucking denied it.
Wow.
That's disrespectful.
We've had some bad times there, though, in Bellevue.
Oh, we sure have.
Oh, yeah?
We were watching this movie there.
Oh,
I'd bring this up again, but we're watching this movie there and some. So, you know, when we watch a scary movie, like when you watch a scary movie, right? In a theater. You ever watch a scary movie in a theater?
Sure.
Do you ever scream?
Mm-mm.
You're a man. Because you're a man. Right?
Well, I don't know. It's just.
Yeah.
I don't let it out.
Yeah, I do. I'm a vocal kind of a guy.
How do you keep it in?
Yeah.
Like, how do you express fear or being like jolted?
I try not to express anything.
Wait.
Keep it all in.
When you. Are you quiet?
Oh, yeah.
Will you close your mouth?
Well, this voice is not conducive for
yeah.
getting a vagina wet.
Like, if you had to say something, what would you say?
Ah, God, come
maybe
on.
Maybe that.
Yeah. Take it, take whore. It. Yeah. You like it, bitch.
Yeah.
My girl likes a real insult.
Oh, she likes insults?
Yeah, but then if I do it in the kitchen, she hates it.
Oh, right.
It's weird,
yeah. So anyway, we were in the theater, and I screamed. We were watching this movie, Hereditary. Do you see it?
Oh, no, too scared.
What?
I saw Midsommar.
Same
guy.
Director.
Yeah, so I couldn't watch the other one.
Oh, wow. Well, you should see it. It's very good.
It's too heavy, man. That stuff bugs me. I don't want to be scared.
What do you watch, Three Amigos?
Yeah, I love Three Amigos. Yeah. That's a great movie.
Ghostbusters, okay.
Yeah.
All right.
Not
but I screamed, and then the lady and the couple in front of us goes, can you keep it down? You know what I mean? If you're going to scream like that, watch it at home. What is she
saying? Watch it at home.
Watch it at home. And I'm like,
this is part of it.
Yeah, and we almost got in a fist fight after.
Whoa.
We waited until they knew that we were sitting in back of them, and the movie ended, and the credits rolled down, and everyone left the theater except us four. Right? So her and I just sat there, and we stared at the back of their heads. And as soon as the lights came out, oh my God.
He turned around and like cussed
us out.
Fucking,
what?
Yeah, but then we went.
He drew first blood, which is a mistake. Art of War.
Wait, he did or you did?
They did.
Oh.
They cussed us out.
We're angry gooks.
Well, they just assumed.
Don't make a gook angry.
Yeah.
You know that old saying.
Sure.
The old proverb that you get from the fortune cookie. Yeah.
I know Shane Gillis. Man.
Yeah. So, you know, it's interesting because, you know, I just have to say this. You know, how do I say this?
Sing it, sister.
I think you know, if I was gay.
Yeah.
Which I'm not.
Jeremy.
That I would find you to be cute.
Oh, thanks. All right? You're cute, too.
I just want to let that sink in.
Yeah, wow. I mean, I think that's... No,
but just let the silence speak for itself.
There was a character on Thundercats that you look like.
I love Thundercats.
Yeah, the little one.
I think you're nervous under because it was intimate what we were doing.
It was
and
totally
now you had
intimate.
To talk over it.
I had to get out of
so
it.
So what? I want you to look at me right now. I don't know. Don't get out of it.
All right.
Don't
say anything. I'm going to try to slide it back in.
Tell me that I'm cute again, right?
Oh, God.
Look at my eyes. You don't talk for 30 seconds.
Hold on. I can't find your eyes.
And you count the... Okay.
All right.
Very funny. Very funny. Uh-huh.
But all no, right. You're cute.
Thank you.
Your feet aren't even hitting the ground.
You're talking.
It's adorable.
You're
okay,
talking,
sorry.
Right? So you're cute again and don't say anything. Are ready? You,
but lock eyes?
But lock
eyes.
Ready? Say you're cute. Say it.
Oh. All right,
so here's what my point though is.
You're cute.
Is that thank you. My point is that because I've seen your stand up and stuff, and there is, you know, you're cute. You know, you can skate. You know, you're from New Orleans. You know, but you have this low self esteem.
Sure.
Yeah. And where does that come from?
I assume it's parental upbringing. Something like that. Bedwetter, braces, curly hair, black neighborhood. It's a big gumbo of bad news.
Yeah.
And I think that probably did it.
You think so?
I guess. I don't know.
Because when you met me...
I was salivating. I was foaming at the
I know,
the
but
mouth.
When you met me, I wasn't this fucking fat.
But you were tubby.
Okay.
You're tubby.
Not a lot of definition.
Let me say something to you, Mark Norman.
All right?
I was on the wrestling team in high school.
Get out of here.
Yeah. What?
Wait. Yeah. Come on. Wait a minute. You were wrestling with your sexuality.
Wow. No, I was on the team, fucker.
Can we pull that up there?
No, I don't have it
Gilby?
In there.
Is it online?
Yeah, but Bobby Lee picture, because there's a picture of him with his varsity pick, like in the wrestling stand.
Yeah.
Whoa, you should have fought Ben Askren.
I think I beat him. That Jake Paul thing.
Same body.
Yeah. Did you see that fight?
Yeah, that was wild.
It was a mess.
That's him in a singlet.
Whoa, look how hot you were.
So that's me, and that's my brother. My brother and I were both wrestlers.
Oh, my God.
Look at the definition of my arms, bro.
Pretty good.
Yeah.
Pretty solid.
I mean, I was 16.
Yeah.
So,
you know, anyone else hard?
I mean, this could have gone, my life could have gone a complete
oh,
direction.
Yeah. What happened?
Stand up.
Mm.
You mean, you find comedy and you go, oh, I don't have to do that.
Here.
Yeah. It's also like, I think guys work on their body. I know some, they say, oh, it's about my health, mm-hmm. right? And they say it's about, you know, I just want to stay fit, right?
Yeah.
It's all about getting women.
You think?
I think deep down inside. I think down the side, they want to look good for the opposite sex.
Right? Oh, when you get naked.
Yeah, or that's why people work out as a, you know, I think, you know, and they get nice cars because of that. And
right.
It's all, that's the basis.
I know a couple juice heads that really are just love sucking their own dick and have no desire to look good for women. They're just, they like have.
Yeah, I've seen that.
Oh, maybe, yeah, maybe
you're
right.
Flexing the mirror all day.
Yeah.
And selfies and shit.
Yeah. But for me, it's like, you know, when you're 5'4", mm-hmm. right, and you're Korean.
Mm. Go on.
Right, and you're living in America, and you're trudging, you know, along in your life.
And you grew up in San Diego,
right?
Which is white,
very white,
very blonde.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So it's like in my early 20s, you know, I still have all the sexual organs that you have, Mark.
Sure.
You know
sure.
What I mean? What's so funny? What's so funny?
You almost forgot his name.
No, wait, I know, because I was getting emotional. It's because I know his fucking name. All right? Yeah. All right. But it's like, you know.
Keep going, Billy. Yeah. You're doing great.